life falls to ruin and pain, unending pain.
How did you get through? Once upon a time. Once. Whew. Once upon a time, in the city of Paris, there lived a man named Gustav Eiffel. Monsieur Eiffel was an iron weaver. He could weave beautiful bridges that stretched further than any other, or a train station as wide as a palace. He wove his iron thread for kings and for kaisers, for presidents and princes. But his favorite customers of all were children, the children of Paris. Every day after school, the children of Paris would run to Monsieur Eiffel's workshop to see what new and exciting toys he had woven for them. A pair of skates for Yvette, a sailboat for Jacques. The children loved his toys, and Monsieur Eiffel was very happy. One day, when all the children were still in school, a little girl entered his workshop. She was everything a mother could wish for, a gilded pearl and azure sashes. She sat very quietly and watched Monsieur Eiffel ply his trade, weaving away at his iron loom. Monsieur Eiffel called to her. Bonjour, little girl. Aren't you supposed to be in school?
No, I don't belong there anymore.
Monsieur Eiffel was puzzled. Certainly all little girls belonged in school, especially at this hour. Then where do you belong now?
On the moon!
Monsieur Eiffel put down his iron thread and looked at the little girl. The moon!
Oui, the moon! It's a terribly long way off, and I need your help to get there.
My help? But I've never been to the moon!
You silly man! Grown-ups can't touch the moon, only children can.
Why can't grown-ups touch the moon?
Because grown-ups fall in love.
And when love is true, it goes waltzing on a star.
Stars are for grown-ups. The moon is for children.
But what are children doing on the moon?
Maman and Papa said that when you lose a child, the child touches the moon. And there they stay, where they dance forever and ever with the tumbling sun.
Monsieur Eiffel was concerned. Where are your Mama and Papa, little girl?
At home, I suppose. But I don't belong there anymore. Just before bed the other night, they tucked me in, they kissed me goodnight, and they said when I woke up, I wouldn't belong to them anymore. I would belong to the moon. And if I was really, really good, I could dance forever and ever with the tumbling sun. I just have to get there.
Monsieur Eiffel was beginning to understand. His heart was sad for the little girl, sad for her parents, and sadder still, for he knew no way of helping her. Little girl, I wish I could help you reach the moon, but I don't know how to get there.
That's all right. I already know the way.
Monsieur Eiffel was flabbermongered. You do?
Of course I do, you silly man! All children know the way to the moon! I just need your help to get there! I have calculated that it will take exactly 1,000 étoile balloons to carry a little girl to the moon. But I'm concerned about flying into the trees or houses of Paris, as I don't want to ruin my dress or scrape my knees. What I need is a platform that stretches way high in the sky, higher than the trees and higher than the houses, from which I can jump and fly away with my 1,000 étoile balloons.
Monsieur Eiffel was impressed. He had underestimated the resourcefulness and mathematical calculabilities of the little girl. I am impressed. I have underestimated your resourcefulness and mathematical calculabilities, little girl.
If you can weave the tower, I can gather the balloons, and then I'll jump off the tower and fly to the moon, where I'll dance forever and ever with the tumbling sun.
It was an ambitious proposal, but Monsieur Eiffel agreed. He immediately set to work designing a tower that would help the little girl reach the moon. He calculated that the exact height of a tower needed to send a little girl to the moon would be precisely, very high indeed, 3 centimeters. He would need 4 sturdy legs for support, a very tall tower stretching into the sky, and the longest iron threads the world had ever sewn. For days and days he worked and he worked. Alone at his loom, he sewed and he sewed. Mr. Ivel wove iron longer and more beautiful than he ever had before. On and on he went, weaving a tower of latticed iron until at last it was complete. When the little girl saw Monsieur Eiffel's tower, she could not believe her eyes.
A tower taller than anything in the whole world, and all for me to reach the moon.
Tears filled her eyes, and she hugged him tight and thanked him for the best present a girl could wish for. When the full moon rose on a cloudless night, the little girl and Monsieur Eiffel climbed the tall, tall tower, together with 1,000 étoiles, shining red balloons split between them. When they reached the top of the tower, they looked out over the city of Paris. There they stood at the top of the world. There were stars above, and there were stars below. Will you miss your mama et papa?
Terribly so. And I know they'll miss me even terriblier. But they said it wouldn't be for long. They said one day, when I'm dancing on the moon, I'll look into the sky, and there they'll be, watching over me, waltzing by on a passing star. So you see, there's nothing to be sad about, because in the end, we all get to dance.
And with that, the little girl kissed Monsieur Eiffel goodbye. Monsieur Eiffel handed her the final red balloon, and off she flew, over cloud and country, over person and planet. The little girl flew, she flew and she flew, past all the wonderful worlds of the universe. First a comet spinning rainbows, then a galaxy swinging waves. On and on she flew, until she landed on the moon. And there she stayed, dancing forever and ever with the tumbling sun. And the little girl was happy. And ever since that day, when a child no longer belongs to the earth, they go to the city of Paris, where they climb Monsieur Eiffel's tower, and a smiling man hands them 1,000 étoile balloons so that they may fly to the moon. For the moon was made for children, so that they may have a place to dance forever and ever with the tumbling sun, while their mama and papa waltz on a star, forever watching through the pin dot sky. And the little girl was right. There's nothing to be sad about, because in the end, we all get to dance. We just need 1,000 étoile balloons and a very tall tower to get there.